children. I am your English teacher. Today we'll study the chapter Glimpses of India about Core. See, in the previous chapter we have studied about Goa. Today let us study about Core. So Coorg is a small district of Karnataka, you all know that, and I hope many of you would have visited when you have gone to Mysore. It's very near from Mysore for Kodagu children. And this district is famous for coffee. Coorg is always famous for coffee. And then today let us study about its beautiful inside, children. So here the author says, the lesson gives us a beautiful insight of the smallest district of Karnataka and its people. The place has an amazing weather throughout the year with enough rain during the monsoon season. The people of Coorg are known to be one of the bravest. Coffee is the main crop grown in this region. A variety of animals can be found here, while the place is surrounded by beautiful Brahmagiri hills, islands and Tibetan settlements. So children, this is about the introduction about the Coorg children. So now let us move on to the lesson. Coorg is a small place, so beautiful that it seems like a piece of heaven has drifted away from God's kingdom and has settled on the earth. It is somewhere between Mysore and Mangalore. It is an area with low hills of unequal height. The men are brave warriors. The women of Coorg are pretty. The place has a variety of wild animals too. So children, here it's a very beautiful place. It's a tourist place also, we can say, children. So here, and it is also known as Kodagu. It is one of the smallest districts of Karnataka, and 30% of the area of Coorg is covered with evergreen rainforest, and the place receives rain for most part of the year, especially during the monsoon season. The period from September to March is ideal for visiting Coorg. The weather is pleasant and there is some rain, which makes it worth the while. The air is filled with the strong fragrance of coffee due to the abundant coffee plantations. See, this is the Coorg dress, you can see here. And the people of Coorg are believed to be a Greek or Arabic background and are generally ferocious. You know the meaning of ferocious, children. We say the tiger is a ferocious animal. So they are also called as ferocious. And see, children, here, this theory came into being because of their dressing style. They are generally seen wearing long and black coat with embroidered waist belt known as kufia. Kufia is similar to the kufia worn by Arabs and Kurds. And see, children, it is also rumored that some people of Alexander's army could not return to their homeland and so settled here while returning from the south. And the people of Coorg marry each other, and their cultures as well as rituals are very different from ones followed by Hindus. So here, how their homes and all will be, you know, the people are very welcoming and warm in nature. They are always ready to entertain with stories of their ancestors. They are known to be independent, ferocious and brave, which is evident from the fact that the Coorg regiment in the Indian Army has received the maximum number of awards for bravery. Almost all the people will be there in Army, Navy, Air Force, children there. The first chief of the Indian Army named General Kariyappa belong to Coorg. Also, these are the only people permitted to carry firearms freely, unlike others who need a license. This shows that the Coorg are reliable too. Marshal Kariyappa's ground is there, children. You would have seen near to MG Road. So, the evergreen forests and hills of Coorg provide water to River Kaveri, a major river in South India. A large freshwater fish called Mahaseep is found in these waters and is looked for by the birds. Squirrels and langurs play in these waters by throwing half-eaten fruits, whereas elephants enjoy bathing in it. The tourists who visit Coorg to relax in the natural beauty of the place also get attracted towards the various adventure sports activities available, like river rafting, canoeing, rappelling, rock climbing and mountain climbing. See children, here these are the adventurous sports they play, and moreover the hills have various paths formed by footsteps of walkers who trek there. Trekking, I think you all know about trekking. So while talking a walk in their region, one may find a variety of animals around them, birds, bees, butterflies around you, while squirrels and langurs keep an eye on you from the trees. Wild elephants can also be found in Coorg. See children, I am showing here some pictures. You can see these. To have an overall look at the beautiful city of Coorg, one must climb up to the Brahmagiri Hills. Coorg is surrounded by astounding places of beauty, like the island of Nisargadhama, while Kuppe, which is India's largest Tibetan settlement. Monks wearing red, orange and yellow colored garments can also be found in the district of Coorg, where their lifestyle is a fascinating view for the travelers, children. And a mix of diverse cultures can be seen here, which represent the heart and soul of India. So this is about the Coorg, children, a very small chapter it is. So if you have any doubts or you want to go and see Coorg, we will plan for the summer holidays. You can also plan with your parents to go to Coorg. So enjoy the place, children, if you go there. And if anybody is there near to Mysore, you can visit there and come back to Bangalore. Okay, children. Now, this is about the chapter. Once again, you enjoy this chapter. By listening itself, you should view that ma'am is taking us to Coorg now. So you'll be feeling how the river Kaveri will be. And now a tragedy has taken place. You would have seen the landslides has occurred near the Brahmagiri Hills, and the Purohit's family is being washed away in the water. So all this you are watching in the TV. So Coorg is a very beautiful place. You have to visit, children. And the writer describes the hill station of Coorg, which is located in the Western Ghats in the state of Karnataka, children. Very nicely he has explained, and it is famous for plantation, coffee plantations and spices. And the women are very pretty. They marry within their community. Kodwas are said to be Greek or Arabic. Their garments are called as kupia. And their main food is, they eat fish. Pig also, children, they eat. The tourists, the major tourist attractions are Brahmagiri Hills, Nisargadhama Island, Bailkope, Tibetan settlements. Okay, so you also imagine that we all have gone to Coorg now. in these holidays, during this pandemic period, we have gone there. You think? Enjoy the chapter, children. Thank you. Have a nice day.